And by the way, same I find with, at least with me, with Shikhar, both of them with me, extremely humble, you know, nothing, not at all. And I really love that relationship, because it's always great to have a great relationship with you and Shiv in that earlier generation,
right?
You know, but to have it with the next generation, not always automatic. And
that's nice about both Shikhar and Roshni. They are, you know, open, and they are, you know, you can chat with them. And
yeah.
To me, there's a greater degree of informality, obviously, with Shiv. He was like an elder brother.
Yeah.
Not so much a thalaiva, as they say in
yeah.
So what I thought was, we talked about, you know, where you grew up, and that was in Pune, right? In Pune.
I grew up in Mumbai, actually, but I was born in New Delhi, again, because of my grandfather being there, as I mentioned to you last time. So I was born in Delhi. Yeah, my mother obviously went to her parents' place for my birth, and she had actually, we won't go into that part of the story, because I think there are other more interesting things to talk about. But it's my father was studying in London when I was to be born, and my mother was absolutely determined for me not to be born in London, but to be born in Delhi. So she came back 2 months or 3 months before I was born, on ship, by the way. So she sailed back to India, and then in Delhi. But then I grew up in Mumbai. So that was the most memorable part of the childhood, that I went to probably one of the best schools in Mumbai, Cathedral and John Connon at the time.
Oh, wonderful school.
Yeah, wonderful school. And, you know, interesting learnings from a very early age about, you know, I was clearly among the poorest people in the class, because, you know, Cathedral has, so I know all the, again, we won't talk about all this there, but I'll talk about some lessons from there. All the very top industrialists, Saurav, in India, whether it is Mahindra or Bajaj, anyone who's my vintage, so I know them from, as I say, I know them from the time when we were all wearing shorts on the playing field, and I didn't care who they were and what they were. But so Mumbai, and then, of course, Ahmedabad, and back to Bombay for the TAS, and then to Stanford.
And your undergrad was in Bombay University, right?
In Mumbai University, in St. Xavier's College, with mathematics as at my undergrad. And that also is an interesting story, because my father, being a freedom fighter, always wanted me to go into the IAS. So his dream was that I would go. So I was good in math. So he said, if you're good in math, then you kind of get very good scores on those. You know, you can do 3 papers in mathematics, you got to do general knowledge, English, all the things. So I, from a very young age, the goal was I would go into the IAS, IFS. It was not going to be anything else.
Yeah, well, you know, that journey which I've written down, it's a journey of being middle class, you know, doing well, you know, with all your distinctions, being a gold medalist there.
Yeah.
So maybe capture a couple of lessons from there, which
you
storytell.
Yeah.
And then what we wanted to do is to take it into, you know, what took you to Stanford as opposed to continuing India. You could have had a brilliant career. You could have been a business mogul. Who knows? Another gymnast.
There's only one gymnaster, but...
In which case, we would all be coming to you and saying, you know, can we do a fundraise with you? we know Shiv's answer always is no. maybe you would have been more kind.
I can talk about that, and that that's a good occasion to talk about the influence of my father, who was a professor. So it was completely motivated by my dad.
So, you know, that kind of, you know, story is interesting, and you know, and then rather than talk about your journey into Harvard, I think it would be interesting to say, you know, what are those couple things, like, you know, you came into Harvard, and I think you came into your own. I mean, how old is Shivam? At least
96, so 24 years now. 23
years now, right? So that's a long stint.
Yeah.
And in Harvard, I mean, I think you're an absolutely brilliant career. We all know, you know, raised this, that you were, you know, right there as the dean in 2005-06 when we came to visit you.
Yeah.
When Shiv and I came to see you, you recall at Harvard, you were almost there.
Yeah.
But then, you know, you in fact did so much work in Innovation Lab, where Shiv came and had a lecture, then design thinking.
Yeah.
And then, you know, when your seminal book, Rethinking the MBA.
Yeah.
Right? There'd be lots of students here who, in the audience, would be students there who'd be wanting to listen and understand, not just Rethinking the MBA, but the principles of rethinking education.
Yeah.
You know, not lessons you kind of quote in your IIM convocation speech.
Correct.
Which I find the audience to be fascinated with.
Yeah.
In how important it is to rethink things. And in design thinking, you're always, you know, putting a framework together, putting all of that together. So, you know, it's like design thinking simplified. Design thinking, how it can apply to our everyday problems. And rather than talk about COVID, which is a morbid subject, unfortunately, we talk about how the world may evolve and how could design thinking, for example, be used as a thinking hat, to use it like a De Bono phrase. Can it be used as a thinking hat? So this was just a broad talk, but now maybe you can dictate how you would like to answer, what kind of things you'd like to inject into it. And, you know, I think people appreciate humor, a certain amount of irreverence, and, you know, stuff that you're good at.
Yeah. So, no, so I think those are all exactly online. So I think once you get towards rethinking the MBA, I'll try and very succinctly talk about the Knowing, Doing, Being trilogy and why that became an important contribution that we made to education generally, right? The Knowing, Doing, Being concept. I'll try and explain it in the context of design thinking very, very simply and easily. And then the other part that I think I would prop, and this may be a good place to end on, Saurav, either of the whole thing or your part or whatever, because I know from the hundreds of comments I got after my IIM Calcutta speech, the part that I have spent a lot of time thinking about is how do you think about the role of business in society? And, you know, Gandhiji's ideas about economic growth on the one side, which many people always know his social justice thoughts, but don't know as much about his ideas for economic growth, which were, of course, several. He never believed in, for instance, state capitalism, and he understood people. So, I mean, he was I don't think you've seen my speech on Gandhiji and the Dandi March. So I actually say that the Dandi March is the first most brilliant example of design thinking that I could imagine. It's a perfect illustration of it. I gave it at it was an interesting thing. They were doing a design thinking workshop and a design thinking colloquium, and they wanted me to give the keynote address. I actually happened to be in India for the HCL board meeting, so they did it around that day, and I didn't tell them what I was going to talk about, and I basically illustrated design thinking through Gandhiji's formulation and conceptualization of the Dandi March. Why was that one of the best examples of design thinking there was in the way in which he did it? We again won't be able to, obviously there's so many interesting things to talk about, Saurav, so we'll have to pick and choose which ones we want to say. Right. So I won't get into that, but I think it's useful for people to remember Gandhiji's seven deadly sins and why each one of them, so it's in the very end part of my IIM Calcutta speech, why every one of them on the one side actually has economic growth, on the other side has social justice, and why he was so worried about, and that's going to be a problem for, not problem, a challenge that we always try to manage, is how do you not sort of reduce economic growth, but at the same time amplify social justice. You know, that is the tension. And I think businesses now will increasingly, particularly in the post-COVID world, have to worry a lot about how you think about this tension. And there's no clear, easy, I mean, everything applies, Saurav, in that same context. You can think about the environment in that context. You can think about, you know, healthcare in that concept. You can think about education in that everything is in that context. So at the, it's a very macro way of framing it, and it's because Gandhiji said it in 21 simple words. It is so powerful that you never forget it. It's so easy to remember. That's what we are after.
I'm going to ask Rohit. Rohit, do you have this YouTube link of Shrikant's? The one on the Gandhi.
No, sorry, I'll have to look it up. I don't have it right now. So he had sent that speech. So I have a transcript of the speech, but I'll have to look it up.
Shrikant, if you have the link,
I'll look for it.
No, because it's an interesting metaphor for application of design thinking in areas. Everybody says, "Oh, design thinking, it must be used in business or engineering or, you know, commercial application." But design thinking can be used in everyday life. It can be used by virologists. It can be used by epidemiologists. It can be used by politicians. It can be used by sociologists. It's a framework, right? And it'd be lovely if you demystify it, and you demystify rethinking the MBA about rethinking also education and how, for example, everybody knew online was there, but you proved it as Zar Shrikant that, and if you don't mind, I would love to use that. No.
So that all came from design thinking, sort of, so we can you know, do again, we can tell a story about it. And by the way, including the principles that we use, you know, about being, I think it will be an important principle for people to follow, which is you have to be forgiving, you have to be patient, you have to be resourceful, you have to be adaptive.
Right.
You know, those are going to be the, so as I describe in very two or three ways, what we did, how we did it, you know, I'll conclude with, so I'll always try and tell a story, but from the story, let an idea, you know, a concept emerge. So, but not, you know, the usual way in which we do it, sort of. So, you know, the method.
And Shrikant, where I think we've been trying to focus, and maybe Rohit will send you Arun Sareen's interview yesterday, or conversation yesterday before the interview. Because it's a very relaxed format.
It's very, very relaxed. I mean, even the other two were fantastic and very relaxed. Yeah,
very relaxed. And you know, there are lots of people who be interested. And you know, we're going to try and you know, at least propagate it within our community, and maybe your office can propagate it within your list of people as well. What would be really nice for you to comment a few thoughts on the deeper changes you see emerging out of the current crisis. And I'm saying the deeper changes are not necessarily a better vaccine or, you know, more usage of masks and gloves and, you know, ventilators and things like that. But, you know, 2-3 years down the line, 5 years down the line, what kind of impact do you see on the economy, work habits, what is Harvard's, one is what is Harvard's viewpoint, but more important, what is Shrikant's viewpoint? I think more people are interested in hearing you. I mean, Harvard is obviously an institution which is much respected, and therefore there must be a Harvard view evolving. But what is Shrikant's view of the way the world will evolve in the next couple of years, and what kind of lasting impact will this whole crisis leave on humanity, economies, jobs, societal transformation? How do you see it, including education, obviously, which is something a lot of people will want to hear from you? Shrikant, we lost you again. Your voice is...
No, I said those are all good directions, and you know, I can certainly pick up on all of those things, and maybe you and I can just go back and forth over the next 2-3 days, just providing small snippets and answers, and you can help shape it because you also know the audience. I mean, I have a sense about the audience, but obviously design thinking means knowing your audience very well and making sure that what you're saying is not so much for the two of us, but for the wider audience that we are speaking to. So you'll be able to guide me saying, okay, cut this down here. Let's do more there, you know, whatever. So I'll take your questions and the roadmap that you have, tell you a little bit about what I'm thinking, you know, not in great detail, just bullet points, Saurav, for you to just react to and a design basically for we might want to think about, and then you can see if that's the direction.
I'm thinking more like, you know, somewhere between 4 and 6 questions in the 25-minute spell, between 4 and 6 questions, how it's going.
Yeah.
And then a similar number between 4 and 6 in the open, you know, viewer questions.
Yeah.
Right. And Rohit, if you could just put all these questions down for him, including the data that's emerging from there. So, and don't use speaker guidelines that I think really work well is quick, sharp, pointed questions, which is my responsibility, and slightly longer, but also sharp and quick answers from your end, which of course you understand. I would imagine that the ratio between me and you will be 10 or 15 to 85-90 from your end.
Yeah. No, that's correct. And I think, you know, if you said 6 questions and if we know that it's going to the 6, then I can obviously pace things also a little bit better, Saurav. I'll try and keep my answer no more to, 2 minutes to 3 minutes, somewhere in that window. I think if it goes too long, 6-7 in these formats, people tend to lose the chain. So it's too long for someone listening to be able to get it. So 2-3 minutes. So I would actually say, let's go for more questions and shorter answers. If we can, again, you and I going back and forth can arrange it. Obviously, you can ask me a question that I could go 6 minutes. But rather than that, let's see if we can break it up into, you know, and it can be a very punchy next question. You know, you're almost there on it, and just 2 or 3. So more, I think, Saurav. So I would, because if I take 25 and after your 2-minute introduction or whatever, if we have 23, 24 minutes, then if you asked only 6, then I'd go, you know, you take 30 seconds or a minute, I'd go 3-4 minutes. So maybe think about more on the 6-7 side rather than the 3-4 side, because 3-4 side will mean that I'll be talking much longer. So if we can go 6-7, I think we might be achieving your goal of both being pithy and yet you being very sharp in your questions and me, you know, responding more. And again, since I'm going to tell a story, it won't feel like 2 minutes, because every time I'll try to tell a story within, you know, every lesson, I'll try and develop with a little bit of a storyline. So hopefully it won't feel like that long, but even so, I think sort of let's plan on 6 or 7 from your side, and then let's think about 1 at the very end. I think that seems to me to be a good, because then no matter what the question from the audience is, there's an ability to bring closure to the.
Yeah, you wrap the entire session up with 1 overarching, all embracing question.
Yeah.
Which you can then coalesce your thoughts, which you have spoken about. Leave people with a sense of optimism about the future.
Yeah.
I think everybody is tired about worrying about vaccines and many people are dying and what ventilators are required.
We don't want to ignore all the suffering. Obviously, we have to be realistic about that and acknowledge it. But there is a lot of positives that is going to come. I mean, zero doubt in my mind that there are a lot of positives going to come out of this crisis. So, I'll pick on 2 or 3 in each of the areas that you have described, and including, you know, that's where I was kind of going with Gandhiji's quote, saying, if I was thinking about what his lessons were, you know, how might I think about what this crisis is going to do going forward? Because there were several during his period of time too, and much worse, and with very little ability for us to handle it. And yet, you know, it sort of had a very different, his leadership at that time had a very different impact on humanity, and has extended over huge periods of time after that.
So Rohit, I mean, we are chatting tomorrow in any case, Rohit. So maybe what we can do is in a moment tomorrow. Put the thing in more, in better context, and also put out the data for Srikant is quite data driven, as you know. And he wouldn't be such a brilliant mathematician and a finance person and a design thinker and an innovator if he couldn't. So let's feed him. Let's give him some stuff to feed on. Srikant, I'll jump off because it's 6:59 p.m. I have a 7 o'clock, if you don't mind. Rohit will walk you through the technicals of how the screens and things will work. And I'm available, as you know, Srikant, anytime to talk to you, anytime, as you know. Can't hear you anymore, Srikant.
I said we'll do that over the next 4 days. So, no problem. I'm looking forward to it, and it should be great fun.
So are we. I mean, in fact, we think it'll be one of our really good sessions. Good sessions.
Yeah. All of them have been fantastic. Yes,
it'll be good.
Thanks.
Thanks.
Thanks,
Srikant.
So,
okay, Rohit.
Hi. So, I think just one point, Srikant, before we begin the technical part, because you have clicked on the link and you joined. So, for the actual session, I'll be sending you a similar link. The process remains the same. You click it, then you allow it to access your laptop. Are you on a Chrome browser right now, Srikant? Just. Okay. Sorry, I think you're on mute. I can hear you.
Yeah, it is on Chrome.
Perfect. And Srikant, just one question. You know, when Saurav was speaking, and I think when I'm speaking also, there is an echo which is coming. So,
correct.
Are you using external speakers for your computer?
No, I'm only using the computer speaker.
Okay,
but I can
turn the headphone
if you like.
Yeah, if it is possible, if it's not too much trouble, can we just check it once?
Hello.
Rohit, can you hear me now?
Yeah, I can hear you now. And are you getting any echo from me when I'm speaking?
A little bit less than before.
Let me check with the team, which is there on the back end, because I think I can hear you very clearly right now.
Okay.
So okay. I am not getting any echo. Okay, team is saying it's still there. So, okay, nonetheless, we'll check it. We'll, you know, also check if there is a way to cut it out. Let's just check the technical part of it right now. So I think the setup is very straightforward.
And then, the only other thing is Ati was just mentioning. Which I didn't even catch, but in the video that you sent, which is outstanding, as I told you, the date that is mentioned is 7th, not the 30th.
Yeah, I know. It's so the creator guy got confused. Yeah, so we're updating it. So it's not going like that. So we're updating it. Yeah.
You're right.
Long story short, Shrikant, because our test was on 7th and the actual on 13th, so the creative guy got confused and he put it 7th. But yeah, we're updating it.
Can you just send me the link after you update it, because I want to send it to several people.
Of course, I will. I'll send you that as well as, you know, your video which you shot, and thanks so much, Shrikant, has come out very nicely. So we'll just put some opening slide, closing slide, just to put some finishing touches to it, and I'll resend it to you. So that you can check it, and if it works fine, then we will put it up.
Okay.
And so Shrikant, this is her primary setup. This is how it will work. Now we discussed about the backup that day. The same link, if you want, you can open in your phone right now. If you have your phone close by, which could be our backup when do you use Android phone, Shrikant, or iPhone?
It's an Android phone.
Perfect. So it will open in Chrome by default, I'm assuming, the link.
So
if you can just click on the same link, open it there.
Okay. And I'm keeping this on, right?
Sure. Let's keep it on for now because, you know, so we can talk.
Okay. I'm just doing allow everywhere, correct?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, can you see me now?
Can you just put yourself on mute on the laptop, Shrikant, so that, you know, there is no echo?
One second.
I'm on mute on the laptop up now.
Yeah, so here it is, you know, your mobile feed. And in case, so the primary way we will go online. Shrikant, can you hear me clearly?
Very clearly.
Great. So primary system, I think, will still remain your laptop. And if something happens and there's a power outage, some issue happens, then, of course, you know, it's just a matter of clicking on that link and coming online. It's a matter of 30 seconds. And that should be in the meanwhile, we can, if at all, you know, this thing happens, we'll run a super saying, you know, please stand by. We'll come back online shortly. And then you can just click on this link and come back online through your phone.
Okay.
If at all. Perfect. So that's a backup. It's backups. Perfect. Backup, you know, in that sense.
Perfect.
So I think I've got two backups.
So hopefully on the computer it will go up. And then if not, then I have my router.
And I have got multiple computers, so I can also make sure that I need to. Okay, good.
Perfect, Srikanth. So I think that is that. These are points we wanted to discuss with you. It's fairly straightforward. You know, it's like a Zoom call. You click on a link and you come online. And I think they're bringing back your, they're bringing my laptop. So if you want, you can disconnect your mobile feed, Srikanth, if you want. Yeah, so now it's gone. I think you are, we'll have to unmute you one. I think you're on mute. On the echo part, Srikanth, I think what is happening is it's basically, the voice from the speaker is sort of going back into the mic and getting channelized like that. Because when you are on mute, so then there isn't much echo. So if you can just go on mute and I'll speak and I'll check the team, ask the team to check. So are you on mute now? Yeah. So Arun, Roshan, can you please check if there's still an echo? Otherwise, I will go on mute once and then Srikanth can speak. It's clear now, right? There is no echo which is coming. Okay, so let's do a reverse. So Srikanth, I will go on mute now and then you can speak. So we will test, which computer is causing the problem.
Okay. I'm speaking and I'm not getting the echo back now to me, but I don't know if you're getting an echo.
So it's clear right now also. So as soon as I think the other person goes on mute, that system works. So that is one solution that we have, but we will check with the technical team again, Srikanth, because this could be a bit inconvenient when it's a free flowing conversation. One person may forget to turn off mute and then becomes an issue. But this is a possible scenario. If at all on the day of test of actual session also, if there is an echo, then probably I'll request you and sort of to mute and unmute as you are speaking.
And then when I went on, we were both on.
Yeah, it seems like that.
Okay, so no problem there. So I think we should be in good shape. We are in good shape, Srikanth. Definitely. Okay, so you will send me two things. One is the video that I can send it over. That's right. And then second is the video that we shot.
Let's put some finishing touches. Fantastic. I'll send it to you. Okay, sounds good.
When did you check on the day?
So I think we should log in 15 minutes before the session starts, Srikanth. So all this echo and any of these things we can check, and if at all it is there, then we can agree on a protocol that mute, unmute, or whatever. We sort of agree on it. And then we can run the session like that.
Okay, so why don't we even have half an hour before? Because then if it turns out that we don't have the time, I can always come back again.
Sure.
But this way, we are not pressed for time too much.
Absolutely. No, happy to do that, Srikanth. I'll also ask Saurabh to do that. So I think we're happy to do that.
Okay. So let's plan.
Perfect. All right, so I'll send you these things, Srikanth, and then very keenly looking forward for 13th, and we'll obviously get in touch. I will send the questions and everything that you have basically that you've shared. I will package and send it to you.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Srikanth. You have a good day. Bye bye.
Thank you. Bye bye.